excuse me, are those Christmas lights?
Yeah, they're just trying to get in the season, icicles, and I want to do a Chevy Chase kind of thing on my rooftop, you know, whatever.
You do know that Christmas is in about 350 days, right?
Well, yeah, but, I mean, why not? I mean, I figure I'll get an early, you know, early start on Christmas this year.
Were you aware that it's illegal to keep your Christmas lights up after January 14th?
But it's the Christmas spirit. You know, Peter Rabbit.
Where's my gun?
And St. Nicholas.
You stand right there.
But officer, I don't understand.
You're going to die for this.
But what is that? Are you bringing in backup?
Yes.
I'm just trying to decorate my house.
I'm going to need some backup on this.
I'm just trying.
I found a drug dealer.
Hold on. I just wanted to make sure that the rest of the neighborhood understood what it was
to be in
the Christmas spirit.
You know what you're
going to
understand right now, you son of a...
Oh, God, get down! Deborah, get down! They're trying to come after us for our Christmas lights! I can't believe it! I tried so hard!
I see that you're having fun outside today, sir.
Oh, yeah, great fun.
Huh, what's that you got there? A little snow?
Yeah. How you like that? Snowball in the face.
Huh. Did you know that it's illegal to throw snowballs here in Kansas?
Well, let me just give you another snowball in the face. Right there. Yeah.
Huh.
How you like that?
I don't like it.
You don't like it? Let me give you another one. I like snowballs in the face. Yeah.
I need some backup.
Oh, God. Backup for what?
You're under arrest. Anything you say can and will be held against you in a court of law.
It was just a snowball.
It's illegal in Topeka, Kansas.
Oh,
and you know what?
God.
It's illegal in Colorado, too.
Why are all these cop cars out here?
Where's my gun?
I was just throwing snowballs. Oh, God. Mother, help me. Oh, no! Hello?
Hi, Mr. O'Kelly?
Yes, that's me.
Are you practicing?
Well, actually, Mr. O'Kelly was my father. I'm just, douchebag O'Kelly.
Okay, were you practicing witchcraft?
Well, witchcraft is a strong word. I mean, Alohomora, you know, I mean, I have a digital wand from, you know, Harry Potter world.
Yeah.
It's from Florida.
I'm going to ask you one question. Are you a witch?
I would say that witch is also a very strong word. What's with the noise here? I mean, I'm not a witch. I'm more of a wizard.
I'm going to need some backup.
Oh, God.
For what? Were you aware that it's illegal to practice witchcraft in Canada unless you're a real witch?
But I'm not, I mean...
Yeah, I don't see any evidence of being a real witch here.
I have to be a real witch?
You have to
why
be a real
you
witch.
Be, oh, God, is that... Why wouldn't you be a real
right,
witch?
I'm going to need my gun.
Oh, my God. I mean, hold on. I mean, I thought it would be like a real witch would be what would get me in trouble here.
Yeah,
like,
this
you know,
is going to get
Salem
you in trouble.
Witch trials. Oh, my God! Why? I mean, I thought... Get down, Deborah! Get down, kids!
Hey, Nick, can I borrow your Netflix password?
Of course, Derek. You can have whatever you want. I mean, my password for Netflix, of course, is Thomas Red Dragon number 2.
Thank you. Okay, I'll put this in my... Wow, this is nice.
Yeah. Yes. Hi, I'm Nicholas.
Hi, Nicholas. We just got a notification that you shared your Netflix password to a non-family member.
That's right. I mean, I thought, you know, I paid for it, so whatever.
Did you know that that's illegal in the state of Tennessee?
No! Are you serious?
I'm going to need my gun. I'm going to need some backup.
Oh, my God.
Let's plant some cocaine.
He's got a gun. It's just Netflix.
Yeah,
I don't understand.
I don't want him to make it to
Whoa,
the court.
Whoa, hey, listen. Ah, it's just Netflix. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Welcome into the Echo Radio Show. It's your favorite host, Derek Daisy, and with me as always, Nicholas O'Kelly.
Now, Derek, do you want to explain exactly?
All right, listen, everybody. As you will learn in all these shows, I'm a fan of memes, so I read a lot of cool ones. And George Takei, he released a video on Facebook a couple months ago about strange things that are illegal.
There are some amazing things that are strange that are illegal.
Yes. We started with four of the ones on the list. it's debatable if it was good or not, but we'll leave that up to the press. I wanted to finish the list, and we'll just talk about it.
Yeah,
not
why
act
not?
It out.
Now, I just want to say,
yes.
Can you believe that, I don't want to say this too loud, so I'm going to whisper.
Okay.
I don't pay for Netflix, okay?
What do you do?
Well, my wife pays for Netflix.
Fuck him. Get my gun. I'm going to plant some drugs on this jerk. That'll make sure to get you through the system real nice. That's how we handle problems here in America.
No, I mean, she has a Netflix account. I just, I use her password, so I can't, I guess we're married, so maybe that's not such a big deal. Not,
yeah, it's family member. It's illegal to share it with a non-family member in Tennessee.
But still, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, come on.
Well, let's go down the list. All right.
I want to hear it.
Number five, selling cold water or soda at a liquor store.
Oh, my God.
It's illegal in Indiana.
Cold water or soda?
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. Now, okay.
Like, who walks into a liquor store and says, you know what? I want to get some Coke.
Now.
I mean, well, Coca-Cola for all you druggies. God.
Oh, gosh. Yes.
Thank you.
No problem. No, I'm trying to think. If you go into Total Wine here in town,
yeah,
it's split into the beer side and the beer and wine side, and then they have the liquor side of Total Wine.
Of course.
In the beer and wine side, they also sell soda.
Yeah.
They sell soda. They sell water. Not on the liquor side, which generally you would not drink soda with beer or wine. You would drink it with liquor. But due to laws in the state, they can't sell soda in the liquor side.
Oh.
So very interesting.
Well, in Indiana, you can't do it at all.
Wow.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
Get out of here. All now, right. Nick, right. I want to ask you, have you ever had an impulse to shoot Bigfoot?
Well, I've had an impulse to shoot your mom. No, just kidding. No, I haven't.
Whoa. All right. Well, it's illegal to shoot Bigfoot in Skamania County, Washington. So if you see him. That's right. There you go. So if you see him in Washington, don't shoot him.
Wow. Have you ever seen Bigfoot?
Personally, no. if you've ever seen a Goofy movie, yes.
Yes.
All right. Here's another one.
Okay,
I think you're going to like this one.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. This is illegal in China.
Okay.
TV shows about time travel.
Oh. Really?
Yeah.
There's a lot of things that I would assume would be illegal in China. I don't know that time travel would be anything that would be made illegal, but okay.
What about like collecting rainwater?
Well, in China?
Yeah. What do you think?
You know, I want to buy in Sam's Club, you can buy a barrel that is designed to collect rainwater and then redistribute it to your water supply,
uh-huh,
filter. That's what I would like to have on a regular basis in our what we know as a free country. So what does China do?
Well, this actually has nothing to do with China. It's okay. Actually Colorado.
Oh.
That it's illegal to collect rainwater.
What? Are you kidding me?
I guess.
In general?
Now, I do want to tell our listeners here that I did not check my sources. This could all be totally false. I'm assuming that George Takei...
Takei. Yeah.
Sorry. God, I'm terrible. Takei checks his sources before he puts it online.
Yeah, I think he probably does.
He seems like the kind of guy
feel pretty confident that he's whatever he posted is pretty... Yeah, it's pretty accurate.
I just don't want to be a jerk and then find out all of this is fake and scare anybody. You know, drinking beer while standing up is illegal in Texas.
What?
Yeah, I mean, I guess it makes sense.
In Texas.
A place where everybody's given a gun at birth and you can't drink while standing.
Oh, so they have to drink beer while they're laying down?
I you know, that's a great question, Nick. You know, but shipping shoes, hats, or fake fruit is illegal to ship... in Italy. It's illegal.
Now, I've been to Italy.
Oh, really?
Yes, I have.
For what?
Well, I was there for a cruise specifically.
Oh, that's
cheating. I was touring Europe.
That's cheating.
But I don't remember them telling us anything about not being able... Now, I was living in Europe, so is this shipping fruit out of the country?
It's fake fruit, buddy.
Oh, fake fruit.
It's just illegal to ship it, period, in Italy.
Wow.
Don't even bother.
Wow.
But, Nick, I got to ask you this question.
Okay, I'm ready.
Before you eat a pickle, do you make it bounce?
Well, I guess it kind of depends on what kind of pickle we're talking about here.
We're talking about a pickle.
Yeah, okay.
That's eaten by a pickle. Okay.
No.
Well, selling a pickle that doesn't bounce is illegal in Connecticut.
Okay.
Take that to the bank and smoke it. I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah, okay.
All right. What about this? Mispronouncing Arkansas. It's actually illegal to do that in Arkansas.
Arkansas?
Yeah. I would hate to get shot in the face there.
Arkansas.
Yeah, I imagine like, you're going to jail for a long time, buddy. That's 10 years.
I'm trying to think of how else you would pronounce Arkansas. I mean...
Arkansas.
I guess. I mean, Arkansas.
Well, you know what? Putting a goldfish in a glass bowl is illegal in Italy.
Oh, my God.
What is it with Italy?
Italy sucks.
Yeah, I really don't.
Italy is like a third world country. I've been there. It sucks.
Really?
Yes, it's awful.
Well, I'm going to tell you what. Singapore is a little different.
Okay.
They make it illegal to import chewing gum.
You know, Disney World does not allow you to bring in chewing gum. Did you know that?
I did not know that, but chew a lot of gum.
They don't sell it at all on the property.
Oh.
And generally, if they happen to catch it at security, they'll make you throw it away.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
How embarrassing.
Yep.
Have you ever been to Denmark?
Yes, I have.
Did you know that naming your baby something uncommon is illegal?
Like what? Thomas?
No, that's common. Okay. We're talking like if you name it like Darth Vader, poop breath, diaper pants.
Like Frederick?
Yeah, no, those are common names.
Oh. Seven.
But in Portugal, it's giving your child a gender neutral name is illegal.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know what that's about.
Like Lindsay?
Like Pat. Yeah, or Casey.
And Pat.
Yeah.
You ready for that
one? I know. Well, you know. Sagging pants that show underwear or skin is illegal in parts of Illinois, Alabama, and, you guessed it, Louisiana.
Interesting that it's not right in Chicago.
Yeah.
I would expect a lot of sagging pants in Chicago, to be very honest.
And I got to be, I'm not here to get into fights with people and the way folks do things, but I just don't get the form or function of having pants under your underwear. I just don't get how
Justin
it's comfortable.
Justin Bieber pants, yeah.
I guess, man.
It's weird.
But you know what? Wearing heels over 2 inches is illegal in Carmel, California.
Okay.
If you're ever thinking about wearing your high heels there, Nick, I do not... encourage you to do so. Now, using too much change in a transaction is illegal in China.
Okay.
Sitting or laying down in public is illegal in Santa Cruz, California.
I'm ready.
And
it kept going.
Okay.
And Virginia Beach, Virginia.
Oh.
Yeah, so don't think about going there, because okay. that's all you do. Oh, being overweight while employed is illegal in Japan.
Well, that happens pretty often for me.
Yep. Spitting in public is illegal in Massachusetts, New York City, and Dodge City, Kansas. And
I guess that's why they want to get out of Dodge.
That's right.
Right.
And then selling cheese that's anything less than highly pleasing is illegal in Wisconsin.
Well, I don't appreciate non-pleasing cheese.
Yeah, me so, too.
There you go.
Yeah, all right. I think this one's the last one.
All right, here we go.
Eating fried chicken with utensils is illegal in Gainesville, Georgia.
Gainesville, Georgia. Okay. Do you eat fried chicken with utensils?
No, I've always eaten it by the hand. Personally, I haven't had fried chicken in a long time. And now that I'm on this diet, I know I'm never going to have fried chicken again.
My wife I love fried chicken.
I know. It's so good.
Now, this last time we went to Disney World, we ate at the Hoop-De-Doo Review.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, is the longest running stage show in America.
Yeah.
Been going on since the 70s. And one of the things that they're known for is the fried chicken.
Huh.
Phenomenal. Oh. I mean, it was phenomenal.
Yeah,
I loved
phenomenal.
It. It was so good.
Good.
And now I want some more fried chicken. What's your favorite fried chicken?
Original.
KFC?
No, I mean homemade.
Okay, yeah.
Now my mom's from Virginia and my stepmom's from Delaware, and ironically, the two things that they did very well was cook fried chicken.
Oh,
and
man.
Yeah, and they didn't cook it very often, so like I loved it. It was so good. And then I learned to cook it a couple years ago. I bought a fryer, much to the objections of a nurse that I worked with.
Oh.
Yeah, she's like, "Listen, you're going to die."
I love fried chicken.
I know, I do too. Why? I hate this.
I like Bojangles. Bojangles is my favorite.
I don't like fast food fried chicken. It's not the same.
Have you had Bojangles?
Yes, I've had Bojangles. It's not. I don't get it. I don't know why you guys love it so freaking much.
I like Bojangles. I don't like KFC.
I like KFC. I like KFC better.
Really?
Yeah.
Than Bojangles?
Yeah.
When was the last time you had Bojangles? Oh, man.
A year ago.
God,
and I haven't had KFC in two
Bojangles.
Or 3 years, but yeah. I don't know. But the one thing I will say about KFC, which really makes me mad, you know how they have those fast food drive-thrus? You ever been in one of those, a fast food drive-thru?
Yes, I've been in
You know how you're supposed to only be in line for like 2 or 3 minutes
yeah,
and you
right.
get your dang food? I do not recommend going to a fast food chicken place like fried chicken, like KFC, because what happens is you get in line and then you're stuck and you got 3 people behind you, 3 people in front of you, and you're like, well, we're frying the chicken. We can't just, like, they don't put it in a microwave like you think they should. So you're just stuck there. You're waiting. You get your fat face filled with the mac and cheese, which is freaking awesome at KFC. They make some amazing.
They do.
Oh, my
they
gosh.
Do.
And then, of
it's
course,
good.
Mashed potatoes and gravy. It's amazing. But if, like you and I in college, while cookout was about 90% of our fat, which if you're not from the Southeast, cookout is kind of like the In-N-Out burger of the Southeast. It's just amazing fried foods, and it's more real and it's cheaper than McDonald's and Burger King and all that.
Exactly.
But you and I had used to go to KFC to get the sliders, and I swear it took us 20 minutes to get out of the drive-thru. And there was no way to get out otherwise. You were stuck.
Now, I'm gonna bring this up.
All right, do it.
Have you had the mobile order at Chick-fil-A?
No, but we talked about this last episode, didn't we?
Not the mobile order.
No. Oh.
Mobile order at Chick-fil-A. It's also in the app.
Okay.
Now, I did mention this in the last episode.
Okay.
We have the app.
You gotta stop going back.
And the QR code.
Yeah.
But It's a new thing that some Disney World kind of doing this as well, but there are some fast food chains that are beginning to do this mobile order thing where you order off their menu through an app, and then you show up at their restaurant, and you go in and you have already ordered, they've already made it, and then they call out your name as if you've been there this whole time, and you pick it up. all through an application. You've paid through it, everything. You just go in there and you pick it up and it's already ready.
I think all of them are doing that. Like Five Guys does that.
It's great.
McDonald's does
it. Love it.
Yeah, I did it with Five Guys, and actually I discovered that they make more things than they show on the menu through the app.
They do.
I got a triple burger.
Yeah, the apps normally have a secret menu.
To
encourage you to do mobile ordering.
Yeah.
Because the drive-thrus have gotten so ridiculous. So ridiculous, in fact, I'm going to bring this up.
Okay.
Okay.
Here we go.
Chick-fil-A is the one that I know that does this, so I don't know that anyone else is doing this, but someone, and I don't know who, has convinced Chick-fil-A that having people stand outside in the drive-thru lane to take your order is somehow more efficient than just allowing them to stand at the window with the headset traditionally and take your order.
I think the thinking about it is... that they know what they're about to cook going forward. So they're like, all right, we got these many orders. We know exactly what we're doing. So that makes the flow a little faster and you're not getting bottlenecked at the one thing. Because you like essentially what they do is they only send those people out to everyone who is like three cars behind the person that's talking to the squawk box.
Yeah, but here's the thing.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. And I get it. I mean, I do. But they have the stations. They have the stations. Now I'm an industrial engineer. Okay. So this is my job.
No, it's
is
not.
Efficiency.
Okay. Efficiency.
Yeah, it
okay.
is. But okay, you have the people at the squawk box, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then like you said, and that's exactly what happens.
Yeah.
You have the people I noticed the other day in the Somerville Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
There were people standing outside of the window, literally beside of the window, handing food to a car outside of the window.
Okay.
Now, I mean, maybe I'm dumb, but what would be wrong with the person in the window?
Dude, they got crap to do inside. I don't know. I mean, like
handing them food.
Listen, Chick-fil-A's doing fine, Nick. They don't need you. The fact, like, I saw a post on one of their billboards that says they're paying, I think, between $12 and $14 an hour to fast food. I mean, that's you have to have like the customer service of like an Apple store or something to work there.
And that's my other problem with all these fast food chains: the people begging for $15 an hour. Now, I understand why. The whole thing is that you have a situation where the economy's not doing so good nationally.
Yeah.
And so people are having to take jobs that were originally, you know, intended to be for college students, high school students, whatever. And you have adults who are not in school anymore needing these jobs. And so, okay, they're asking for $15 an hour or whatever. It's because they're not in school. They can't just make whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I get it. But in my opinion, okay,
yeah,
people need to understand that these were intended to be low-paying jobs. Just because you need more money doesn't mean that, you know, taking orders at a fast food restaurant is going to pay you more.
Well, Nick, as much as I know you want to turn this show into a political show, I won't let you, but I will tell you this. I like that a fast food worker has enough money in 1 hour to pay for one membership of Netflix.
Ooh.
Segway!
Interesting.
Every show, Nick, the day before the show, Nick will send me a bunch of headlines that he wants to talk about, and I know a good segue when I see one.
No.
Oh, yes. Today, we're going to be talking about Netflix. Woo-hoo! Ready to have fun.
That's right. I am ready to have some fun. So, Netflix, Derek, this week has been catching up to Disney. Have you noticed this?
No.
Have you seen this? Have you noticed this?
No, I've not. I see the headlines. I don't read them because I don't want to see the exact same thing Nick is about to tell me to pass off as his own thoughts and ideas.
Now, here's
better.
The thing.
Here we go.
Netflix is catching up to Disney in terms of stock price.
Oh.
There's a few caveats to this, okay?
Of course, they don't have
now,
perks.
Netflix has hit a stock price at an all-time high, by the way.
Yeah.
Of 338.62 dollars per share. That was on Tuesday of this week, or last week. Putting the internet video giant stock market value within a hair's breadth of a much larger competitor, Walt Disney. Walt Disney's at about $154 billion versus the Netflix of $146 billion. So basically, last week, Netflix increased their stock price by about 2%. Now, here's the funny thing. Okay.
I'm ready to laugh.
If you I don't know about laughing. If you take away debt.
Yeah.
Okay. And just talk about cash value.
Yeah.
Disney is still above Netflix by about $40 billion.
Yeah.
Which is significant.
Yeah. It's all right.
But there's something to be said about the fact that Netflix, which started out, if you'll remember.
Yeah.
As basically a mail order movie
Bride.
Service.
Oh, yeah. Mail order. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Because I used to subscribe to it in college. I did the DVDs for a while, and then I started getting the Blu-rays, and then they came out with the Netflix Instant Watch, which had primarily B-movies. Like, I remember getting Honey, I Blew Up the Kid.
Yeah, exactly.
And movies like that. And then eventually, like, Spider-Man 3 showed up, which was a terrible movie, but still a high-end movie to hit the streaming service, and then it took off from there. That's where I discovered The Office.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And the question is... You can't take away from the fact that from that position, Netflix has managed to turn itself into a major competitor on not just a streaming service platform, but a major competitor in content in terms of digital media. I mean, they are making... some highly competitive shows, movies. I mean, of course, we're all going to say House of Cards, Stranger Things. I love House of Cards. Of course, it's canceled now, but that's another story.
Well, it's not canceled.
Yeah,
it's coming back.
Hopefully,
just without. No, it's definitely coming back. It's coming back with Robin Wright.
Yeah, which I don't. Yeah. I don't like that. But
know.
Anyway,
hey,
but
for
it was
all
great.
The bad things
but
Kevin Spacey's done, he was a good actor.
Regardless, the first however many seasons it's been have been phenomenal.
Yeah.
I mean, great.
Yes.
Stranger Things.
Yeah.
Love it.
I would love to see a Netflix world theme park.
Me too.
Where you get chloroformed in the
House of Cards
ride.
Why not?
Get pushed in front of a bus and see what it feels like.
Yeah, exactly.
Or a train.
And also, talking about Marvel, Marvel has done all of, well, not all of their, but, well, I guess all of their television shows since the Marvel Cinematic Universe started. Mm-hmm. You have Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, Iron Fist.
Mm-hmm.
These have been really good. I don't know if you've seen them.
No,
Daredevil especially.
I just
very,
don't
very
have
good.
The time anymore. My focus is so torn.
Well, I will just say Daredevil, Punisher, the best that's on there.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic. I mean, acting, story-wise, very, very good. Iron Fist was okay. Luke Cage was pretty good. But anyway, they're great.
Yeah.
So original programming-wise, Netflix is really standing above.
Yeah.
Now, the one thing to keep in mind is that Disney has not yet come out with their streaming service.
No, they're waiting. Well, now, they're getting it together. They're trying to figure it out. I think they're going to do original Star Wars programming.
How great would that be?
Well, I know they're going to do it. They've already hired Jon Favreau to write and executive produce.
So we know that's going to be incredible.
Yeah, it better
incredible.
Be.
Incredible.
It's going to be like Star Trek, The Next Generation kind of shows, Voyager, you know, like it's a live action show.
Yeah, exactly. Now, Disney just finished purchasing Fox.
Yeah.
That's going through, I think, by the end of this year. They had a few caveats with their news things.
They split that off into its own thing.
Yeah, so they had to come to some agreements with the news portions of the deal.
Yeah.
But it's basically done at this point, which is big for the MCU because you've got X-Men and Deadpool and Fantastic Four finally coming in.
Yeah.
So that's cool.
Yeah.
But there's another big thing here.
What?
Hulu.
Yeah.
Hulu, which Fox owned, a major portion of now belongs to Disney. So the big question is, I understand, and there's a new Netflix series, actually, that I want to check out, Lost in Space.
Mm-hmm.
That's a new...
I've heard a lot of good things about that.
I want to watch it.
Yeah.
Very interested to see. I mean, here's the thing. Now, I mean, I want to get into this because there are some aspects of Netflix that, in my opinion, make me believe that they have, in some ways, hindered the movie realm, okay? Mm-hmm. Hollywood, for example. Let's take Adam Sandler, for example.
Okay, we're taking him.
I am hard-pressed to find... In fact, everything that Adam Sandler has done with Netflix specifically,
yeah,
which was something Wexler. I don't remember the name of it. And then
I don't even remember.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And then also the, The Magnificent.
Oh, that sucked. Magnificent Seven? Whatever it was. Or Ridiculous Seven?
The Ridiculous Seven. Let me just type in Adam Sandler Netflix. I'm just going to do it because I don't want to get it wrong.
Mm-hmm.
He's had a couple things.
The Do-Over?
The Do-Over was one of them.
That was okay. Yeah, it's moments.
Okay, here we go here. Filmography. Sandy Wexler was one of them.
Oh, yeah.
The Do-Over. The Ridiculous Six.
Yeah. Six.
These are the ones that came on Netflix, straight to Netflix. And let's just, I'm just looking at Rotten Tomatoes right now, okay? Sandy Wexler has a score on Rotten Tomatoes of 29%.
Nice.
That's pretty bad.
Yep. It wasn't that good.
But not as bad as The Do-Over, which has a resounding 5%.
Really?
And it gets better.
Uh-huh.
The Ridiculous Six has a score on Rotten Tomatoes, this is real.
Yeah.
Of 0%.
Yeah, it was bad. I really thought it was stupid.
So the question becomes, has Netflix given actors the opportunity to come out with crap content and still sell it?
Well, I mean, ultimately, like when Netflix was asked about it, they were like, so, you know, these are bad movies. Why are you guys buying it? He's like, dude, more people watch these movies than they watch anything on our catalog.
Yeah.
There you go. That's it. That makes it worth it because every hour they're not watching somebody else's show, that's less money they got to pay to them, and they get to pocket that.
And now Netflix has been, in the past week, very interesting, has been rumored to be purchasing some movie theaters in Los Angeles, in New York City, so that they can stream their own original content to movie theaters, specific theaters. Now, this rumor has been trounced by Netflix because they have said, no, we don't want to do that because we want to be able to provide our content to the consumers directly.
Mm-hmm.
My whole thing is that I don't think that they actually want to go head-to-head with real movie studios.
Yeah, there are some people that are really against that. Steven Spielberg is like, I just don't think that Netflix should be in the Academy. They, you know, they can have the Emmys, but no, not the Academy Awards. And
yeah.
But there's a lot of stinginess to that. I don't know. That sounded like a very pompous thing to say. I'm like, dude, a movie is a movie. Like,
and I have been surprised by some of their content. For example, there was a movie that came out with Marlon Wayans.
Yeah.
Which I'm not a big fan of the Wayans brothers. I mean, they've, you know, through the years, Major Payne. There's been some comedies that were good.
Yeah, he's had some good ones.
So, okay. But there was a movie that came out that was filmed in Charleston. Now, we're from Charleston. We record in Charleston, so yeah. I watched it for that reason, basically.
Yeah.
Because it was filmed here. It was called Naked.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought to myself, this is going to suck, but I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
It was hilarious. Like, it was really good.
I never saw it. Yeah.
It was all about, like, time travel. Like, he gets stuck. It was like Groundhog Day. He gets stuck in a loop. And he's supposed to be getting married that day, but he wakes up, like, it's kind of like Hangover, where he wakes up, he doesn't remember the night before, and he has to relive the day over and over until he can figure out what happened and why he's not able to get married and this whole thing. It's really good. Like, it was really good.
Yeah.
And I laughed hysterically through this entire movie. I would recommend it to you. Go watch it.
Okay.
And there's been a few others like that on Netflix.
Yeah, there was, when we first met, was one.
Yep.
And that was really funny. But it's similar concept, except it was he would go back in time. It's kind of like Butterfly Effect. He met this girl at a party, and then he got put in the friend zone. And he was like, oh, why did this happen? And then he goes to this bar, and there's this, like, antique picture taker.
Yeah.
And he puts the quarter in, and then it takes him back to the day he met her, and he figures it out. So he's, you know, redoing everything, and he's trying to, you know, change it so they're together. And every time he changes it, it's just the worst thing ever.
Yeah.
And he does it several times. So time travel. Yeah. Yeah. Which is illegal in China, as we've learned.
So, I mean, I think that Netflix, they have good, they have money.
Yeah.
I think they have a lot of debt.
Yes.
And this was something else, and I this is one of the reasons why I wanted to get into this tonight, because I think it's very interesting. Mm. But there was an article that came out on Business Insider. A Wall Street analyst, thinks he figured out the real price Netflix would need to charge in order to break even. And he says it would destroy the company's growth.
Yeah, $20, huh?
And he says that they would need to charge about $15.
Okay.
Whereas now they charge $11.
Yeah, and they keep going up.
So my question to you... Now, we both have Netflix, right?
We do.
So, would you pay $15 for their streaming? Now, this is for their streaming. Same thing you get now.
Yeah.
Which I think you pay $10.99.
Yeah.
Or somewhere around there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Would you pay $15.99? Would you pay $19.99? Where would be the limit for you?
I think 20 is the highest.
Yep.
I mean, kicking and screaming and complaining. Because like I've done the 4K version of it before, mm-hmm. and I was paying like $14 a month already.
Yep.
And it stings, it sucks, but that's why I just stopped doing Hulu and Netflix. I was like, well, I'm not going to pay $30-$40 for streaming.
Yep.
I just don't want that. So, I will continue to not have Hulu if I have Netflix. Now, you know, I have Amazon Prime as a part of my Amazon Prime membership.
Yep. Me too.
And it has a lot of great content as well.
It does.
I haven't seen a lot of the original stuff, but they have a lot of great movies. Because I'm just a sucker for nostalgia.
The entire Sabrina the Teenage Witch series is on there. A lot of TGIF, Family Matters.
I'm not a teenage girl. Thank you. But yeah, Family Matters good. Probably 20 is the top. Because that's why I don't do Sling and I don't do DirecTV Now and all that. I just... $35 is a lot of money for DirecTV Now.
The thing is, I pay right now, if I was to drop my... I pay for cable.
Yeah.
I pay for cable, but it's a bundle with phone and cable and internet. I did it because I came back from Europe, and you get the 12-month deal, and I thought, well, I want to watch Homeland on Showtime. There's a few... shows on HBO and on Watch and so forth. So I thought, okay, I'll do it. Mm-hmm. I'll probably drop it after this first 12 months.
Yeah.
But if I was to just get internet, like just internet through the cable company, which is where I want it, because I don't want to get internet through Verizon mm-hmm. or AT&T. Yeah. So, you know, cable and Google has, what's it called?
Fiber optic.
I don't remember the name of it, but they have their own thing coming. It's not available at this where we are right now.
Yeah.
So the fastest internet available to me is cable.
Mm-hmm.
To be able to get fast internet, it's like, I don't know, $65 a month.
I pay 90 for a gigabit of speed.
Yeah. So just internet is $70 minimum.
Yeah.
Well, I think my package is $120.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, in my opinion, I'm sitting here thinking, okay, well, if I drop the cable and the phone, I'm still going to pay $70.
Yeah.
So, to get everything for $120, okay, I mean...
That's $500 a year, roughly.
Yeah, I mean, it sucks, but...
Do you watch TV that much? That's the reality of it.
And then I'm sitting here on my couch and I'm watching Netflix and I'm watching
The Office again.
Yeah.
Again. I know.
I'm watching The Office.
I feel like I'm really just subscribing to Netflix for my Office. Like, I could just go buy The Office and stop doing Netflix.
Yeah. And I did that in Germany. I bought a bunch of stuff on iTunes.
Yeah.
Movies and TV show, their application. I have a bunch of stuff on there. But there are some things on cable that, you know, I simply can't, that I can't do. That I simply can't do without cable. HGTV, Food Network, HBO, Showtime. And I think to myself, could I do without it? Mm-hmm. Probably.
Yeah.
Do I want to do without it? I don't know.
I'm just not from the generation of cable. I don't know. Like, I'm really glad that I'm not obsessed with it. I don't, you know, like, HBO, I do it for Game of Thrones. And then I unsubscribe. The HBO Now.
And that was the other thing. I was thinking to myself, when Game of Thrones comes back out.
Yeah. I'll give them their money. I'll give them their $30, yeah. Right? Because then during that time, they have a completely new list of movies that I haven't seen or nostalgia movies, you know. I'm a sucker for nostalgia, but well, we'll see.
This is the problem, though. I mean, here's the thing. I am very excited for the a la carte experience to cable.
Yeah.
Where you can say,
buy what channels you want.
Buy what channels you want. But I've been thinking about that.
Yeah.
What if they all cost $5 to $10?
Then no. It's just not going to happen.
That's my whole thing.
I'm like, why not? But why can't it be a $1 or $2 channel? You know, like a History Channel. Like, there's only like 10 channels that I ever really care to watch anymore. And you know, like, it'd be History Channel for me, maybe Discovery Channel, Food Network, maybe HBO. HBO is $15, though.
I'm just wondering, will they be a dollar?
No. I mean, I think there's some channels that they will be, yes. Because they're just, they don't have that many subscribers, like Lifetime.
Yeah, well,
like, who the hell's paying for Lifetime?
Yeah, Lifetime, yeah, sure. But like, you know, HGTV or NBC or ABC.
I mean, they're licensing most of their stuff out to Netflix already.
Well, that's true. So. But if it goes to a la carte,
yeah.
I think what we're going to see is about $5 per channel.
Well, then it wouldn't be worth it. But
exactly.
But how do you get 60 channels for $35?
I don't know.
So
that's my whole thing.
That's what I mean. Some channels are heavier. The sports channels are heavy.
So
ESPN is almost half of what you pay for that stuff.
And ESPN, that's a big reason why Disney's losing money.
Uh-huh.
Because ESPN is tanking.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's my whole thing. I wonder to myself, what will the a la carte, are we ready for a la carte? I don't think we're there yet.
No.
Because I don't think that they have a business model yet.
Right.
That will allow the consumer to pay an affordable price.
Yeah.
Now, if you only watch one channel, okay.
Yeah.
But if most of your programming has come from Netflix, but what happens when all of those channels, for example, Disney's about to go off of Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
That's taking away everything that's ABC.
Yep.
All the Disney movies. That's a huge...
But that frees up a lot of money for Netflix.
It does indeed.
And but then they got to be able to replace it quickly.
Exactly. So, but Disney's about to own Fox.
I know. Yeah.
So what's going to be on Netflix after that? I mean,
well, they've already pulled off like Family Guy and things like that. Like most of the seasons.
So I just wonder, can with their debt that they already have, not charging enough.
Yeah.
Can Netflix really go head to head with Disney, or would they have to restructure the business model to start putting out more real movie content?
Yeah.
I mean, they have some original programming, but in my opinion, I wrote a blog about this, I think they're looking more for quantity over quality, whereas they saturate the market with a bunch of original programming, so you as the consumer say to yourself, there's a lot of new shows I can watch. I can't watch it all. Why do I need cable? But then when you watch it, you see things like The OA. Did you ever see The OA?
No.
Horrible.
Oh.
Don't watch it. It's horrible.
No, okay.
I mean, I watched it thinking to myself, this is going to be good.
Yeah.
I got to the last episode and I thought to myself, when's this going to get good?
Yeah. Yeah. 12 episodes into it, like, oh, man.
And that's not to say that they don't have good original programming, because they do.
They have a lot of they do have great shows. They're really good in comedy too. They get a lot of these comedy specials on there, which is excellent.
Yep.
They have a lot of strong suits. It reminds me of HBO. Netflix is just its own version of HBO.
Yep.
But we'll see.
We will.
Yeah. Now, I saw something on Twitter.
Yeah.
The other day, and it just gave me goosebumps.
Oh, God.
The Rock.
Oh, yes.
He's hot.
Oh.
He gave
absolutely.
Me goosebumps. No, there was this girl. Next on Dateline. There was this girl who made a video asking him to prom.
Yeah.
And this is so cool. He tweeted this video of her. So she's in class, and over the intercom, it's The Rock. And he's like, hey, so I bet you're all wondering why The Rock is talking on your guys' intercom and all that. He's like, well, a very special young lady, I think her name is Katie, reached out to me and asked me to go to prom. And unfortunately, I'm right now shooting Jungle Cruise in Hawaii, so I can't be there. He's like, you know what I'm going to do for her? I already rented out a theater with 232 seats for you to bring your friends, everybody, your family, anybody you want to bring. You guys get popcorn, candy, get whatever you want on me, and you guys get to go watch Rampage.
Wow.
I'm so sorry I can't be there, but I know you're going to have a great time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, how cool, man. Like, he said he was very impressed because, girls of his stature, big Hollywood girls are like intimidated by him, won't talk to him.
Right.
He's like, I just think that it's amazing that you had the confidence to ask me, And he's just like, I loved it. So he was texting her and all that. I just thought it was really like, God, how cool, man.
He's a cool guy.
What a cool guy.
He really is.
Own the world.
I think he's a class act. I think he's a real guy.
Yeah.
Now, I'm a wrestling fan. I don't watch it regularly now.
Yeah, well, that's good.
But when The Rock was there, mm-hmm. That's what I like to watch. I go back. If you belong to the WWE Network,
nope.
You can go back. You can go back though and watch any old episode you want to.
Yeah.
The Rock. I mean, he took this industry by storm.
Yeah.
I mean, he was amazing. And you go watch him, and he's just so captivating. It's like watching Tiger Woods. It's like, when someone says to you, do you want to go watch a professional golf game? You say, is Tiger there?
Yeah.
I mean,
because who else? he's the rock star of golfers.
That's what The Rock is. Yeah. I mean, if you go back further than him, it would have been maybe Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
But in his time, The Rock was the reason that everyone watched, wrestling.
Yeah.
And I also, I'm a fan of Fast and Furious.
Mm-hmm.
The movies, I think they got better when they added The Rock.
Rock, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, they're better. And he's so great. And yeah. I'm excited to see the Jungle Cruise movie that he's doing with Disney. I did not see the Jumanji. Yeah. I didn't see it.
Again, I told you, it's good.
Yeah, so I'm excited to see that. But with Rampage, now, we talked about this a couple of episodes ago.
Yep.
With, of course, I've played the game Rampage.
Yeah.
It's, I would say the storyline behind it's relatively shaky.
Yeah.
There's not much to it.
Yeah.
It's pretty much you're fighting with large animals, whatever.
Yeah.
But.
It's like Godzilla. It's like an unlicensed Godzilla.
Yeah, basically. Yeah, right. Pretty much. So, opening weekend in China, however, Rampage brought in $55 million.
It's better than Star Wars. Star Wars made like $26 million, and that was it.
I'm just here to tell you, that's a lot of money.
Yeah,
for a movie like Rampage, which, okay, it might have been relatively expensive just because it was all CG.
Yeah.
It wasn't $55 million. That was just China.
It did amazing here.
So,
it's the number one movie in America.
So the Business Insider came out this week with an article saying that The Rock, with that take in China, has basically proved himself, and I tend to agree with this assessment as one of the, maybe the largest Hollywood stars in America today.
Yeah, oh, easily. Now, I have to ask you, because you being a political guy, yep. you who's been talking about retiring other show, oof, that's hard. The Rock has mentioned that he wanted to run for president in 2000.
Oh, man.
So I know you're a conservative, Nick, and you're not a big, like, I want a rock star for president, but I'm curious. The Rock runs for president.
I don't know. I think that the I'm going to start calling this the Donald Trump effect, that people in Hollywood, people with an image, now think that because Donald Trump won, that they can also run for president.
Let's leave that out of it.
I think
The Rock.
The Rock is very charismatic.
Yeah.
He has a big following. I think he could win.
Yeah. Do you think he'd be a good president?
The problem is I don't know much about The Rock.
Yeah.
I know about his character.
Yeah.
I know about his characters.
Yeah. How amazing
but
would
him,
it be to have a
Dwayne Johnson? I don't know.
I mean, but that's a guy you want to win.
Now, there is an SNL skit where he is... I think he's playing Barack Obama. Have you ever seen this?
No.
There's a skit where he's pretending to be Barack Obama, and he's got the, you know, the big ears and everything. And
I know I've seen the Bambi.
It's the Rock Obama is what it is.
Oh, okay.
Oh, man, I wish I could find this thing.
The Rock Obama.
Yeah,
that's
it's
great.
The Rock Obama instead of Barack Obama, and it's just hilarious. Yeah. I mean, I could see it happening. Now, where our country would be after 4 years of him, I don't know. Because I don't know who he is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, and also, it's not like you just walk in and it's like, oh, this is peaches and cream, you know?
Yeah,
it's,
exactly.
It's a mess.
But there's one thing to be for sure.
Yeah.
The Rock, I mean, putting China even aside,
yeah,
I don't think he can do any wrong right now.
I know.
The Rock.
It's crazy.
I mean, Moana... loved it.
Yeah.
Jumanji, you said it was great.
I liked it.
Fast and Furious, better with The Rock.
Yeah.
If Rampage can pull in $55 million, The Rock is doing something right.
Yeah.
There's another thing, too. Did you ever see The Rundown with Sean William Scott?
No.
Also had The Rock in it. Yeah. Fantastic movie. Great movie.
Yeah.
This was before he really made it really big as a movie star.
Remember, Scorpion King was his first movie.
Scorpion King. This was after Scorpion King. Rundown, though, fantastic. Mm. I mean, great movie. Not because of its cinematic value, but just it's a fun, really well-written, and the acting is great. Yeah. I mean, you're watching this movie and you're thinking, is this The Rock?
Yeah.
Who is this guy?
Yeah.
It's great. I would highly recommend it. And so I don't think he can do any wrong right now. So, biggest star in Hollywood? I'd say
so. Oh, yeah, I'd say so right
now. Who's bigger than Dwayne The Rock Johnson?
No one.
No one.
No,
He doesn't have any scandals.
Yeah.
That's a big thing.
I know. Nowadays.
I think that's a big thing.
Or they're dead.
Yep. Well, speaking of promotional subjects.
Yeah.
Okay. Amazon has a cloud business, and they're selling a blockchain product. And this is where people can develop software using a template, okay, for the cloud. So you want to develop a software that operates on the cloud.
Mm-hmm.
Amazon will sell you a template with which you can build off of to make it easier for you as a programmer.
Now, what if I'm not a programmer?
Well, you might want to ask Chevy Chase that.
Okay.
Because here's what they're using in order to promote this. They call it blockchain products.
All right.
They are using a skit from Saturday Night Live starring Chevy Chase and Dan Aykroyd.
Classic. So this old guy's doing it, huh? Chevy Chase looks old.
Yeah, that's... Oh, my God. He does, doesn't he? Did you watch Community?
No.
It's really funny. It's got the guy from... Oh, gosh. What's his name? From The Soup.
I don't know.
He's in everything. Anyway, it doesn't matter.
From E?
Yeah, from E.
Okay.
The Soup,
I
that
guy.
Yeah, he's in it. It's basically like, it's kind of like a Parks and Rec kind of show. Basically you have, I'm trying to pull up this video, but it won't let me because it says it's not available, even though it was available earlier today. It's very frustrating. Yeah, I'm very frustrated about the whole thing. I had the whole skit pulled up, ready to go, and now it's saying that they've taken it down.
Well, that's what happens.
Yeah. So anyway, the skit was Shimmer Floor Wax.
Mm-hmm.
And Amazon is using this skit in order to promote their this product. And it was Chevy Chase and Dan Aykroyd doing this skit. Oh, is this going to let me do it? This might let me do it here. They were where the floor wax doubles as a wax and a whipped cream. And it's so bizarre to have Amazon using this as a marketing tool. And it just goes to show that improv comedy remains something that is still relevant today.
Oh, yeah.
Unbelievable. All right, here we go.
New shimmer is a floor wax.
No, new shimmer is a dessert topping.
It's a floor wax.
It's a dessert topping.
It's a floor wax, I'm telling
it's
you.
It's a dessert topping, you count.
Hey, calm down, you two. New shimmer's a floor wax and a dessert topping. Here, I'll spray some on your mop and some on your butterscotch pudding. Mmm, tastes terrific.
And just look at that shine. But will it last?
Hey, outlasts every other leading floor wax 2-1. It's durable and it's scuff resistant. And it's delicious. Sure is. Perks up anything from an ice cream sundae to a pumpkin pie.
Made from an exclusive non-yellowing formula.
I haven't even touched my pudding and I'm ready for more.
But what about black heel marks?
Dirt, grime, even black heel marks. Wipe clean with a damp cloth.
Oh, sorry, honey. I'll clean that up.
Oh, no problem, sweetheart. Not with new shimmer.
New shimmer. For the greatest shine you ever tasted.
I'm trying to understand how Amazon made this their commercial, though.
I don't know. I mean, it's a blockchain product, and some people don't understand what that means, that you have a template to build a software program, and so sometimes you're quote-unquote talking about two different things, but it's the same thing.
Oh, okay.
And so there you go, right. Saturday Night Live from 1976.
Yeah, I know. I really was picturing these just the old versions of Dan Aykroyd and them like coming on the stage and doing this for old time's sake. But okay, it's the
no,
actual
they
original.
Use that actual original skit to be whatever to promote this new thing that they're selling. It's hilarious.
All right, well there you go.
So, there you go. All right, well, anyway, you've been listening to the Echo Radio Show, and we try to do this every week on Sunday night, 8 o'clock, and then Wednesday nights, 8 o'clock, and we want to showcase you.
Yes.
That's right. If you are an artist.
Yes.
Or a singer, songwriter.
Yeah.
Comedian, whatever.
Performer.
Performer in general. We want to have you on the show. Why not come on? Talk to us about what you do, how you do it, why you did it. And, you know, we'll promote you here on To The Echo Radio Show.
That's right. We talk about you on Twitter, talk about you on Facebook, write a blog about you. You know, we do everything we can to get your name out there and hopefully you bring your listeners in to listen to us because that's really what it's all about.
That's right. I have been a Twitter fiend this week.
It has. He's
and,
got a lot of friends lately.
That's right. And we want to put out a call to all of you listening that if you have not heard us or followed us on Twitter, go follow us on Twitter. Mm-hmm. Follow us on YouTube, Spreaker, Web Radio, at ToTheEcho.com.
Yep. ToTheEcho.com is a big one. Because you'll be able to get links to all these things from there.
That's right. You can subscribe to us on iTunes Podcast.
That's right.
To The Echo Radio Show. But go to theecho.com. Why not?
Yeah, you can subscribe there.
That's where it's at.
And you can find us on SoundCloud.
Yeah, SoundCloud, YouTube, yeah. Podbay, yeah. Podcast.fm. We are literally all over social networks. Yeah. So if you do not know where to find us, then you're not trying hard enough.
Yeah.
So,
and we got some fun stuff planned this next week, too.
That's right.
I'm always in my little factory making commercials.
That's right. And keep up with us at Twitter, because we had a couple of new submissions for songs that we had, the Silver Snails. You can go check them out. Mm-hmm. Great new music video. So check them out as well. We've got some new, we had Windchop on a couple weeks ago. Yeah. You can check out a couple of new bands that we tweeted from them. From the label that they're on. Mm-hmm. So just keep up with us on Twitter. I mean, yeah. Why not?
Love to have you.
It's amazing.
Absolutely.
So I'm Nick O'Kelly. This is Derek Daisy.
That's me.
And you've been listening to the Echo Radio Show. Right here. ToTheEcho.com, Spreaker Web Radio. Search for To The Echo Radio Show.
And check out our merch store, too. We got some shirts and hats and glasses, everything.
Just Google us.
Yeah.
To the Echo Radio Show. You'll find us.
I hope so.
You've been you. I've been Nick. That's been Derek. And we're glad to have you here.
Yeah.
And we'll see you next Wednesday.
Sunday.
Sunday. Sorry, I get confused. Next Sunday, 8 p.m. To the Echo Radio Show. Have a good one.